That is a keep. Well, maybe we should have boarded out the Fester Gloom, come to think of it. Then again, our opponent had Welcome Turn. So there is a way to get around it. But yeah, Fester Gloom, I should have just boarded that one out. I was looking too much at the cards that I could board in, rather than thinking about what cards I could actually board out, which is an easy trap to fall into. But I'm pretty sure it's gonna win us the game somehow. That's typically how it goes. See, well, opponent is mana screwed. Probably when he finds his third land, it's gonna be a bunch of 1/1s somehow. And then this Fester Gloom will be good. Maybe, maybe. Okay, well, he did find the third land. So currently his hand is filled with good stuff. Into the Void will be important this game, I'm pretty sure. Not yet, but... well, this is kind of the worst curve. Into the Void, which is not good yet. A bunch of 5 drops, a bit too many. I could attack. Then he blocks over here, and I have to use Fester Gloom to get rid of it, which... it's probably the best value I'm gonna get out of Fester Gloom, but still not a trade I'm interested in. Could just deck here with Typhoid Rats. He probably trades, which is probably fine. Yeah, that's definitely an okay trade. So let's just attack here. He takes it. Acceptable. Well, that's not really a good follow-up. That card's not going to do anything. Nor is this Research Assistant. Oh, yes, the minus 5, minus 0. Really? Really? Okay, well, you deserve this one. Well done. You got me. Spider, annoying. Well, this is kind of the worst time to draw an Evolving Wilds. There is a downside to this. I could attack with boats. That doesn't really help at all. I could play Into the Void. Yeah, I'm gonna use my mana on creatures over the course of the next couple of turns anyway, so might as well get a tempo boost here. Also allows me to get in for some damage. And let's just sacrifice this here before I forget. Just gonna replay the spider or maybe the tree. Not sure which one. I'm gonna make either the vampire or the maggot. If I make vampire and then give it flying, he's gonna block it with the spider. I guess I could kill the spider. But if I make this, yeah, then I give him an incentive to double block. When then I wreck him with instant speed flesh to dust. That's probably best. Yep. And again, a life. Oh, boom. Oh, yeah. Playing the island because it might be important if I draw 2 consecutive lands that I can play multiple cards when I hit 8 mana. Also relevant if I draw Jace's Ingenuity. The bluffing value of holding lands doesn't really apply when my opponent is so far behind and doesn't really care what to play around. Living Totem, sure. That's fine. Ooh, la la. It's not bad. Attack with the maggot. and the soul, because yes, this is a real card. Yeah, now my opponent's down to 9 life. I guess I can make the spider, but then I'll just kill it with flesh to dust. And he'll probably lose to the Soul of Ravnica. Walk in turn. Maybe he has Titanic Growth. Once he gives +4/+4 when he's blocking. Sure, then I just flesh to dust it. He doesn't have enough mana to activate this yet. I guess I could Fester Gloom before combat. But if my opponent then has the Titanic Growth, which I assume he does, because like with so many cards in hand, just playing a 2-drop and passing seems unlikely. He's gonna pump it. And then I can't really attack anymore and kinda lost my turn. So that also doesn't seem very good. On the other hand, now I can just keep this back and then attack with the Maggot. In which case, he doesn't have good blocks for the Maggot. Yeah, that might still be better, actually. Then I still have Flesh to Dust in case, well, I need to kill something. Yeah, let's do this. I mean, if I use Flesh to Dust here, then Fester Gloom is never gonna get any value. And now at least the Fester Gloom will cancel out against the Titanic Growth that is likely to be in my opponent's hand. Okay, just resolves. That's unexpected. What does he have then? I don't know. But then all of a sudden, this thing cannot really attack anymore. Well, it could still, and he pumps this guy in the Maggot trades for his Sentinel, thereby taking out a possible flying blocker. Yeah, it's probably still more valuable. Maybe I should have attacked with the Child of Night as well. Yeah, I guess that was the play. That would have been better. If I attack with Child of Night as well, then, I mean, he could block it here, which means he gets a free kill of Child of Night, but then he doesn't have a good block for the Old Feast or Maggot anymore. That would have left me in a better position. Especially with him at 9 life. Yeah, now we get this. Which is still okay. But it would have been better had I also attacked with the Child of Night. So that was a mistake. Still, my opponent is hopelessly behind. If he plays one flying blocker, I will kill it with the Flesh to Dust. Even if he has something better, like, I don't know, Island and Crust, I'm still in excellent shape. What does he have here? Turn to Frog is kind of the thing I'm worried about. Now also Peel from Reality. He probably has Peel and wants to bounce this. In which case, I should attack him with, no, just this. I mean, attacking with this as well would be better if he had Turn to Frog. But if he has Peel, then he can get a free block. Yeah, this is okay. So, Soul of Ravnica once again. He still needs some answer. He basically needs to play his Netcaster Spider and then land Vaporkin or something in order to survive. And even then, I'm way ahead. So he might have Ranger's Guile here. Which, still fine. And he still jumps, even if he has gather courage as well. He goes down to 1. He cannot actually kill my Soul of Ravnica. So might as well try to kill my opponent here. He doesn't have anything. Fine. And we got there. On to the next round.